most common types of mixtures are solutions, suspensions, and colloids. Let's take a look at some examples of all these types of mixtures from our everyday lives. Solutions are mixtures where a solute dissolves into a solvent. Coffee is a solution where two solids, instant coffee and sugar, are dissolved into a liquid, hot water. The particles in a solution are evenly dispersed, and you can't see the solute particles because they're spread uniformly throughout the solvent. Solutions are homogeneous mixtures. We use substances that dissolve for many different purposes. An example is when nail polish is removed. The solid nail polish is the solute, and the liquid nail polish remover, acetone or propanone, is the solvent. The nail polish is dissolved into solution by the solvent because there's an attraction between the particles of the nail polish and the remover. Solutions can also be mixtures of liquids, like when you add soy sauce to broth. The soy sauce is the solute, and the broth is the solvent, and together, they form a solution. Then there are solutions of gases and liquids. Soft drinks are an example. The solute, carbon dioxide, is a gas. The solvent, water, is a liquid. And alloys are an example of a solid solution, or a homogeneous mixture, with at least one metal. For instance, steel is a mixture, or alloy, of iron and carbon. By combining substances, we're able to achieve different physical properties such as increased strength. Suspensions are a type of mixture in which an insoluble solid is suspended in a liquid. The solid mixes, but is not evenly distributed like it is in a solution. Suspensions are a type of heterogeneous mixture. For example, if instead of putting sugar into a cup of hot tea, you put in sand and then stirred it, the sand wouldn't dissolve in the tea. The sand would mix with the tea and then settle to the bottom of the container as sediment. Sand at the bottom of the ocean or in a fish tank are examples of sediment. If you stir it up, it becomes a suspension, but soon the solid particles settle to the bottom. The particles in the solid do not dissolve because they're too large. Colloids are another type of mixture. Sometimes a river or creek may appear brown in color, and this is often caused by tiny particles of soil, like clay, floating within the water. The particles are too small to drop to the bottom of the water, but not small enough to dissolve in it. So it's a colloid, a type of heterogeneous mixture. In colloids, particles are dispersed through a medium, which is known as the dispersion medium. The dispersion medium in a colloid can be a solid, a liquid, or a gas. Substances that are spread through the dispersion medium can also be a solid, liquid, or a gas. Blood plasma is an example of a colloid, where solid blood proteins are dispersed through water. A gel is a type of colloid involving solids and liquids. But this time, the solid is the dispersion medium, or the substance found in the greatest proportion, and the liquid is the substance which is spread through it. Gelatin desserts are perhaps the best-known examples of a gel, but there are a number of others, including some hair gels. Emulsions are colloids where the dispersion medium is a liquid, and the dispersed substance is also a liquid. Salad dressing is an example of an emulsion, where oil and vinegar are the main components. Milk is another example. Water is the dispersion medium, and a liquid fat, a type of lipid, is the substance dispersed through it. Detergent is another example of an emulsifier, which means it's a substance that forms emulsions with other substances. Soaps and detergents are a type of emulsifier known as surfactants. Fats and oils don't dissolve in water, but adding detergents can help fats and oils to mix with water to form an emulsion. In this way, detergent is able to help remove fats or oils from where they aren't wanted. Liquid foam is an example of a colloid where a liquid is the dispersion medium and a gas is spread through it. Shaving cream is an example of this. Whipped cream is another, where air bubbles or gas are dispersed in the liquid cream. Solid polystyrene foam, or styrofoam, is an example of a colloid where the solid is the dispersion medium and gas is spread through it. Styrofoam is sturdy and lightweight and has many uses in building insulation, flotation devices, and insulating coolers. Smoke is another example of a colloid where solid particles are spread through a gaseous dispersion medium. Smoke is a solid aerosol. Colloids are everywhere in our daily lives and can be a mixture formed from combining solids, liquids, and gases. Mixtures are all around us. Many of the everyday products and materials we use are in fact mixtures. Mixtures can be any combination of different states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas, mixed together without a chemical change occurring. A mixture can be a solution, suspension, or colloid. An example of a solution is when a liquid solvent, such as nail polish remover, mixes with a solid solute, such as nail polish. Solutions can also be a mixture of two liquids. An example of a liquid solvent and liquid solute is soy sauce in broth. They can also be a mixture of a liquid solvent and gaseous solute, such as in soft drinks. Mixtures can also be a suspension. This is when the particles are too large to dissolve. An example of a suspension is sand in water. If left, the sand will settle to the bottom as sediment. Between solutions and sediments are colloids. The particles are too small to dissolve and too large to become sediments. There are many examples of colloids in everyday life, including sols, like blood, and aerosols, like smoke. We use many colloids in our daily lives, including gels, such as gelatin desserts, emulsions, which are found in salad dressings and detergents, and foams, such as whipped cream and styrofoam packaging.
If you like this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.